Thank you so much to all of you for sticking around. This conversation is really a conversation around how we can join together as the community that we are to really focus on enabling what we believe is the most important skill for the next generation of learners, and that is creating, which all of you have mastered based on the fact that you're here. So how many of you remember asking yourself this question, what do you want to do when you grow up? How many of you are still asking yourself that question? So what or who or how was it that you somehow came to that decision? What was the inspiration? Who was the inspiration? This has to be an interactive conversation at this point in the day. Mom. Aw. People, games, experiences, teachers, kids, moms. Anybody else? Students, struggles. Yeah, for me, failure. A lot of it along the way. So it's not lost on me that I'm standing here today because of the community, the country that I was born into. If there was a different country, a different community, my path would be perhaps non-existent and filled with a lot more struggle than I personally have had to go through. I feel like it's a privilege, it's an honor to be able to reflect back on what do I want to be when I grow up and to be able to constantly ask that question. And I think many of our youth today around the world are faced with, obviously, the same question, and also part of a set or series of education systems that frankly just aren't aligned with the opportunities that they will be able to walk into. So what this conversation won't be is a conversation about how we can change that system from the inside, but rather a conversation around how we as a community can continue to join together to create inspiration so that one day, perhaps, that system will change. But if not, along the way, the youth have the opportunity to be inspired by us and all of the experiences that you're creating. But first, a little bit about me. Like you, I've spent most of my adult life and younger life trying to level the playing field. And again, by that, I mean for those of us who were not born into countries or communities that allowed for us to dream big and achieve it, how could we provide that same inspiration and opportunity? So as a product of the digital revolution, my first view almost 20 years ago was that it was all about access. If only we could provide access to the millions of learners around the world, then that would be the answer. And about a decade of education technology product launches globally, about a decade later, I realized, of course, that access is just the beginning. And so what I thought at that point in time was that it's not just access, it's deeply engaging learning experiences, just like the kind we find in games. And so I then pursued and tried to shift my career more into the games industry to be surrounded by you, the incredible game designers, that I felt like could really understand how to both intrinsically and extrinsically motivate people with deeply engaging experiences. That brought me to Glass Lab, where we had the opportunity to bring the best of the game industry with the best of learning and instruction. And by marrying the two, we proved, alongside with all of you, that game-based learning was actually more effective than traditional classroom instruction from the education system. So then I thought, ah, we've got it. It's about access, it's about deep engagement and effectiveness, and still, we were searching for this scale. And what I realized then, of course, is what all of you contributed at the beginning of this conversation, that it's about people. that at the core of all of this, about finding your dreams, fulfilling your dreams as creators, it's about the relationships that you're able to build with others and to learn from others in parallel with the gaming experience. So then, a few months ago, I decided to take this incredible opportunity to join Unity Technologies. And you may be asking yourself, what does this have to do with everything that we've just discussed? But what I feel like I found at Unity was the combination of all of those key elements that can help us create and unlock this change at scale. And what I want to walk you through today are these three key stages of, first of all, how we're all democratizing creativity, enabling everyone to be a creator. Secondly, democratizing opportunity, ensuring, again, the country, the community that you're born into is not limiting your ability and your opportunity to fulfill your dreams. And then third, democratizing impact, how we at Unity will continue to give you the tools that you need to scale and reach your change. So quick download that most of you are aware of, but if you're not and you haven't been using Unity, quick refresher. We've been around for over 10 years, really with a mission that has not shifted. First and foremost, to democratize development, giving you the same tools that AAA game companies can use to be able to create and scale their games. Secondly, helping you solve hard problems. You as the community, we're listening to you and determining what are the tools that we can give you to help you solve your toughest problems. And third, enabling and scaling your success. I'm really grateful that the team made sure this was added in because this slide wasn't working before. This is just a quick shot of daily downloads that were happening on May 8th around the world. And again, for those of you who are not aware, the Unity Engine is a service that manages all of the game loads that happen globally. So really demonstrating the incredible reach you have when you're creating and developing with Unity. With over half of the experiences that are created in mobile have been created by Unity. And then finally, when we look at this frontier, about two-thirds of VR experiences being created in Unity today. What that translates to, sorry if this is a repeat, it's been in a few of the talks already, is that for you, our 6 million creators and developers, you're reaching 2.4 billion devices based on what you're creating. So again, this massive opportunity for you to be able to democratize and scale creativity. So just a quick lesson. Again, this is probably the worst way to teach, me standing in front of you, but those of you can chime along with me. As a reminder, we've had and are in the midst of three industrial revolutions. The first and second industrial revolution really being focused on the skill of replication, creating processes, replicating that processes for the objectives of scale and efficiency. Really the education approach that we have today, focused in the beginning around rote learning, is created to be able to serve both of these industrial revolutions. As we know, in the mid-80s, when we began with the digital revolution that we're still in the midst of today, the skills of creativity, collaboration, critical thinking were the key skills that we need. And I'm sure you've heard the talks that I've heard over the last day around how difficult it is to hire the talent that we need for this stage that we're in today. And it's becoming even more difficult as we move into the fourth industrial revolution, which we're on the precipice of, which is really around how we're merging together the needs of the real, the virtual worlds. Things like Internet of Things, virtual reality, and big data, all coming together for the fourth industrial revolution. And so this, to me, is really the urgency around how do we enable and ensure that everyone can receive the skills of creativity and learn to become a creator. So we've thought a lot about this scale at Unity and really tried to understand what can we do to contribute to this vision of enabling everyone to become a creator. The first step that we took, most of you are aware of, is that anybody can download the Unity editor for free as a personal edition. And as an education institution, as a student, you can use that edition for free in perpetuity. So really ensuring that the same tools that allow large game studios and small indies to be able to scale to the masses, we put the same powerful tool in the hands of students and beginning learners. The second thing that we're just in the midst of, that really, again, this is a call to all of you to collaborate with us, is creating the courseware, the certifications, the badges, the whole learning paths for the variety of learners that we're serving. So what we're really focusing on is how do we partner with best-in-class learning creators to be able to support students, hobbyists, and professional learners in their ability to learn how to create, and even more so, becoming game designers, game developers, automotive designers, architects, as we move into the space of virtual reality. Thank you. I love the verbal feedback. The more the better. Feel free to cut me off. All right. So that really, again, is around democratizing creativity. I couldn't help but put in this amazing photo of students from Washington Leadership Academy, a charter school in Washington, D.C., where there is a fusion of project-based learning and virtual reality brought together in their curriculum throughout their school. And the head of the school knows that impacting just 200 kids at once is not going to be enough. And so they have plans around how they can launch holographic teaching. So they could have an educator from anywhere appear in a hologram to be able to teach their students. And vice versa, how can they create this virtual learning opportunity for schools around the world? Really dreaming big. So the second area of democratizing opportunity, this harkens back to, again, it's really about the people, it's about the relationships that we're able to create in this community that propels us forward. At Unity, what we decided to do last year, under a year ago, is launch Unity Connect. If you're not aware of it, it's a global talent marketplace specifically focused on creators, leading with the portfolio of your work, your certifications, your badges, the evidence of your competency for anybody in the world, having the opportunity to collaborate with each other, to hire from completely different cultures and countries. Again, I believe that that diversity is going to bring about the best creation of experiences that we can have. So back to, it's not the country or community that you're born into that could limit or enable you, and really how we can try and level the playing field for all the creators around the world. If you guys haven't met Gemma Busoni, she is unbelievable. She is definitely here tomorrow. I don't know if she's here in the audience today. She graduated from high school in just 3 years and spent her weekends at VR boot camps and hackathons, just trying to learn more and perfect her skill. At one of those hackathons, she met her co-founder, and together they've launched Discover Labs, which is focusing on creating virtual reality learning experiences for middle and high school kids so that they can learn in a much more engaging way than she felt she was able to. So really, you know, watching Gemma move from her inspiration to fulfilling her dream that quickly gives me a huge amount of enthusiasm and confidence that this next generation of creators can really write their own destiny. And then finally, democratizing impact. So I've spent the last 5 years working with developers and myself, to a lesser degree, on Unity, and realizing that there is just incredible opportunity for what the editor already provided for us. As some of you may know about Glass Lab, it was really an effort around how we looked at gameplay analytics to be able to bring together the data that can demonstrate the learning impact to both the learner themselves and other key stakeholders. And what we found was that the power of that data was so strong, but it was really difficult to create that underlying data architecture and infrastructure and then the analytics on top of it. And so Unity, as you most of you probably know, has already invested in a very strong analytics set of analytics services. And those analytics services can be just as powerful for learning designers and assessment designers when you're looking at educational data mining, EDM, to be able to create these robust assessments. So continue to look for innovations like that from us as we really focus on you, this learning community, and the changes that we can be making together and ensuring that the access and the engagement can lead to greater impact. So on a final note, Adam Gazzelli, most of you probably know, and Akili Labs is so inspiring in his efforts to launch this new industry of digital medicine on, I think, the third level of an FDA trial now to prove that playing games can be more powerful than taking medication for ADD and ADHD. And we'll see the results of that later on this year. Really exciting and inspiring to see this work. So on that note, I wanted to thank all of you again for sticking around for the second to last talk. Open it up to any questions or comments. I've got a few members of our team here in the audience taking any of the feedback that you give us back to our teams to see how we can work with it and improve it. And on a personal note, I hope my son Isaac, who I brought on this trip with me, has given a little bit more thought on what he wants to do when he grows up and knows that he can keep asking that question his whole life. Thank you.
Hello, thank you. Have you ever considered we're already inside a hologram?
Sorry, I didn't actually hear that. Could you repeat
that? Have you ever considered we're already inside a hologram?
I have not, but now I will. Thank you.
Hi, so I started building a 2D game with Unity, and the online educational stuff you guys have is awesome. The downside is that I'm building it for iOS, and everything was running cool on my Mac until I brought it onto the iPad, and the iPad choked and died. I was wondering if you guys were considering doing a track for performance for 2D games on iOS, because that would be extremely helpful. Like, how can you check for performance? How can you ensure that when you bring it onto your tablet, it's just not going to die?
Thank you. Okay, I'm not sure if we have. I know we're making more investment in the 2D side, but I'm not sure the answer to that question. Okay. But feel free to ask us on support.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
I just want to say that Unity walks the walk in offering all that for free. I know many students that have benefited from it, so thanks.
Thank you. And if you guys do know great students and great educators who really have embraced this, Eric Martin, Eric M. at unity3d.com, is leading now all of our community efforts and ambassador programs. So we'd love if you could send him names.
Hi, can I?
Yes.
That's a good question. So I'm at Owen Gottlieb. I teach at Rochester Institute of Technology, and we teach with Unity all the time. A lot of the work we're doing now is helping students spin off their own companies. And so some of the engines that we're using have end-user license agreements that allow for an evergreen agreement post so that they can actually be sold. I may be wrong, but I think the current EULA for Unity doesn't allow for that. Are there any thoughts about moving into an evergreen model, such as so that we could spin off more companies that are coming out of educational programs?
Thank you for the feedback. I'm not aware at this time of any changes to the EULA, but we'll take that into account. And would love to know more about the work you're doing too, so feel free to reach out to us. Thanks. And there's one here, if there, okay.
Thank you. John German, I put people and projects together at the United Nations, and the obvious question from your remarks about getting the best talent from all over the world is, you know, what would unleash that? You know, what's standing in the way now? Is there any barrier that you would like removed? I'd like to help remove it. Thank you.
Could you just repeat that? For some reason, the audio here is really hard.
Yeah, it's hard. You talked about getting the best talent from the world, you know, to be able to get to its highest potential. And I want to make that happen. I want to see that happens more quickly and more surely. So is there anything you see that you need? I mean, you're doing everything you can do as Unity, but what do others need? What do you need from the member states of the UN? What do you need from other businesses? What do you need from the foundation community? What do you need from NGOs?
Let's go to dinner. So truly, I feel like that one of the biggest and fastest opportunities we have is supporting the continuing education of our amazing teachers globally. So really investing in how do we think of creativity as a competency and working with them to create the best lesson plans and courseware and materials, having corporations and foundations fund that work as well. They're making you run.
Hey, Jessica. Steve Isaacs here. I'm super excited that you and Eric are on board and what's possible now moving forward. I'm just wondering what your vision is for having, you know, a community of educators and students similar to maybe the Unity Connect or maybe right within Unity Connect, as well as an extension to, you know, develop that and nurture that community.
Is Eric here? Eric, you want to answer that? I believe empowering my team on the spot.
And embarrassing. wait, Steve, where are you? Okay. So the question is, how do we get more students to share their work on Connect? So if you are an educator or if you have students, we want to start building out an ecosystem where if you're teaching with Unity, whether post-secondary or secondary level, or you're already just learning on your own, whether through a formal education program or not, we want to have all of those different groups on Connect, and we want to build out the programs that Jessica mentioned, the ambassador programs, that'll allow people to share their learning resources and tools so that everyone can not just have to go off and do the quest on their own, but everyone is learning from what everyone else is doing. So like Jessica said, email me, it's Eric, E-R-I-K-M, at unity3d.com, and we'll start making this list of awesome educators and students. Is that correct? Awesome. E-R-I-K-M, at unity3d.com. Oh God, you're all gonna email me.
Greg Garvey, Quinnipiac University. Don't you have a certification program, and how does that align with the Connect and Ambassador programs or initiatives you've discussed?
Excellent. So we have one certification offering out right now, which is a beginner game developer certification. We will be announcing and then launching additional certifications that will be happening in 2018. So those will be advanced certifications for gameplay programmers and technical artists. We think it's a little bit too early to put in place certifications for VR developers. As we kind of watch that, the requirements of that role in the industry mature, we'll probably move more into the certification space for that those specific roles.
And how do you anticipate that secondary and post-secondary higher ed should integrate those certification programs into their curriculum?
Great question. So the certification that is available right now, as I mentioned, is the entry-level beginning your career certification. Just for those of you who are not aware of certifications, they're very robust, long assessments. And so what we have done is a very thorough job task analysis to create these certifications. And then we have a curricular framework that covers what we think is necessary to be successful in these roles. What we would love is for you as the community to work with that curricular framework, share with us any lessons or courseware that you think is relevant and strongly aligned to that curricular framework, so we could then review it and give it sort of a stamp of approval globally so that more people have access to courseware that's aligned to the certifications. And then what we're doing on the demand side is ensuring that industry really supports and approves those certifications so that we can create more pull for the job opportunities. Thanks for the question. All right, well, once again, I feel so honored to be here to serve you and want to continue hearing from you, our community, on what we can do moving forward to create the best tools and resources for you to scale your impact. Thank you so much.